3, 2, 1. Hello, this is the quinoa lasagna, take one. I'm preparing.
Take one, we're not doing it more than once.
This is a establishing shot. I'm going to get the quinoa down now. Darling, where did you say it was? I'm not familiar with your setup here. I'm just getting things.
You live here.
That's darling. Yeah, but I don't know what the quinoa situation
is. Quinoa is above the fridge.
Above the fridge.
In the cupboard.
All right. Okay. Okay, it's not really about me. It's about the lasagna. But above the fridge? Well, I have to set, look at that. I have to take all this down. So I will have to pause the video.
I told you to do it.
Right. Go ahead and laugh. Laugh. All right then. Well, obviously the labors of Hercules have begun. So, excuse me, I will be back. All right, I am bringing 2 cups of water to a boil, and I'm putting the quinoa in it. And it just occurred to me that this is replacing the actual lasagna noodle.
Well, not really. It's the base of it.
Is there a lasagna noodle in this?
No.
No, it's replacing the lasagna noodle.
No, it is not. It's only at the bottom.
Is it called? It's called quinoa lasagna. Yeah. There is no lasagna noodle in it.
No.
Ergo, it's replacing.
No.
It just takes some while
it's
to get used to.
It's not the vegetable.
It's a revolutionary idea.
Anyway,
it's not a vegetable. It's kind of a legume.
This is a cup. This is going to go in.
2 cups.
We're bringing it to a boil, then we're throwing this in. We're going to let it simmer for 15 minutes, then we're going to fluff with a fork. We're going to spray a 9x13 inch lasagna pan with Pam, and then we're going to spread the quinoa over the bottom, and we'll get back to you with
yes.
more.
Yes, continue. It's my movie. Right? That's what yes, she, Allan, what
it's
she
your
said.
Movie. But I'm the star.
You're always the star.
No, I'm not. All right, so Allan is now dicing up 3 onions. It's supposed to be a cup. They're small. We have our quinoa cooking.
And there's cheese coming.
We have 2 tablespoons of olive oil in the pan. We're going to put into that the three small diced onions and a pack, 8 ounces of mushrooms that we've chopped finely. And we'll get back to you. So this is Allan's rant about garlic. The recipe calls for 2. I told him to put in 3 because we like...
How can I have a rant?
It was a rant. I told him to put in 3.
They're old
As
garlic,
you can see,
and you don't know what the official size of... Ow! Ow! Does it call for a human finger too?
No, it does not.
Well done.
So he put in like 20.
Don't get me excited.
I
put in 20. And you know, you've got the evidence. There is no 20, not even close.
Okay, so we are browning the onion and the mushrooms. Then we're going to throw in the garlic.
Did you have any problem when I was cutting those onions?
In the meantime, I have mixed the fat-free cottage cheese with an egg. And into that, I am going to put oregano, basil, and Parmesan cheese, 1/4 cup. And I'm not sure, I'll get back to you on how much of the basil and oregano. Okay.
Wait. What about me? What is my role in this?
You're chopping garlic.
So we're doing all of that, and we're processing everything else. And as you can see, the garlic is next to nothing now that I've taken off the ends. Old garlic doesn't have the same flavor, you have to understand.
So you will see that we have at least.
And you don't know,
doubled,
some of these recipes call for those giant
the garlic
cloves.
Blah, blah.
But you like garlic is also good for you, and it makes you live forever. So. All right. You probably heard that. Did you hear all that?
Yes.
So, I've got the fries, garlic and the onion, got the quinoa balling, she thinks she's burned. Are you feeling better?
I don't think I'm burned, I'm scalded, because he does not follow direction.
Count to 10. Count to 10.
To the moon, Alice.
10, Allan.
To the moon, Alice. That's right.
Anyway, now, the cheeses I will be selecting for this recipe are a combination of Monterey Jack, cheddar, and Havarti. I find that the combination works well with the onions and
that's not what's happening at all.
Now, I have found through constant research on the internet and also what Alex Jones has said.
No. Alex Jones? Who's Alex Jones?
He's the one that tells you that everything is a false flag operation and the government is...
So into the cottage cheese and egg
is
mixture.
The Havarti and the...
You are putting 2 tablespoons of dried basil.
Dried basil?
Oh wait, I think it's 2 tablespoons.
Oh wait, we have to go consult the internet where Alex Jones lives. Okay. What do we see?
Oh, a half teaspoon dried. Uh-huh. Half a teaspoon. Oh, good thing I checked. Yeah. And a tablespoon of dried oregano.
It's a good thing I reminded her.
Yeah.
Half teaspoon. Oh, well, this is how we cook. Anyway.
Half teaspoon of dried basil and a tablespoon of dried oregano and a quarter cup
of... Is this on? That's
Parmesan.
Still on. Is that supposed to be on?
Yes, it's supposed to be on.
Good job. I have to fluff it? Oh, something's going on. Something's happening. All right, folks. It's okay. Everything's okay.
Why do I love you again?
Because it's my the recipes come out quite well. You'd be surprised. Mm. No, actually, no. You probably have a whole list of them. There's a whole selection.
Okay.
Yeah. Now we have to put the spoon in and measure. That's it. Two level. It's a level. She's eyeballing it, but it's a level tablespoon. Should I stir it together?
Wet thing that
I
put back in there.
What is it? No, that's for future use.
Wet.
Well, that's because it's ready. What are you going to put dry goods
stir.
In?
Stir. Stir.
First it's wet, now it's stir. Stir wet, stir wet, stir wet. All right.
Is everything cooked and translucent in there? No water?
Mm. Okay. It's got its moments. There we go. All right. I would say close. Okay, and how are you doing? You're putting your stuff in there. You're doing your business.
Matza or parma?
Matza. You see, she doesn't know. I'm telling you, the selection of cheeses is key to the execution of this recipe. Because the quinoa is replacing the noodles.
Do you not hear it?
That is flavor sizzle. So I can turn it off then, is what you're telling me?
No, because you're going to put the pasta sauce in it.
Mm-hmm. So add water?
Now I'm assuming that this cottage cheese mixture is supposed to take the place of ricotta, which is quite yummy and delicious.
Yes, I would imagine. Well, people put cottage cheese in lasagna. And by people, I mean me and everyone else.
People put ricotta.
Some people.
Okay, I can go back up.
Okay, well, I'm stirring.
Multitask,
darling. Yes, well, okay. Basil. What's the filing system for basil?
Sadly, that is the filing system for basil.
I still love
her. Oh. Here, go. Oh, no.
Wait, I need three arms. Okay, I gotta go, kids. I'll be back. Folks. All right. All right, here we go. I've got the sauce ready. All right, now, after I have spread Pam on the dish, everything... That's what's happened.
You after take the quinoa. You did.
Yes, 80%. Now, I take my... Those are my hands, by the way. Called illusion.
You got some pretty girly hands, buddy.
Yes. Yeah. Okay. I had my manicure.
Wow.
Yeah.
And a lot of quinoa.
Yeah. Okay. Well, that is replacing the pasta. It is. It is by for a fact. I got to stir now. Okay.
With the pasta, we're one layer on the bottom.
Yeah.
Which it is not.
But it is replacing the pasta, which is wheat. Pasta is wheat, and quinoa is a substitute for wheat. It's what the Peruvian people eat. Now that we've taken all their quinoa, they have none for themselves. So.
Is that true?
There's some logic to that. I mean, that's where it comes from, and we all love it. So it means they're selling it to us. I don't know what they're eating instead.
Okay, so Allan is now going to put 1/3 of the sauce evenly over the quinoa. It's messy.
All right, I'll spread. Is that about a third? Spread a third.
I'd say a little more.
Okay.
Okay, it's all over the bottom of that pan.
Okay, I'll wipe it with my third hand.
Videotaping this with my mouth.
You're not videotaping it with?
No. A spoon would be good rather than getting it all over the pan and all over
I know. Well, I'll wipe
stove
it. I'll wipe it. I'm wiping. I'm trying to get the layer of sauce. A wet rag. Okay. We're getting
all right.
PG.
Wipe it.
Okay.
It's such a mess. Then we put a layer of zucchini.
Okay, and a tiny layer it is. Now, as we put the zucchini on, it's important to remember that symmetry is important in these cases. So Dale now is showing you, as I've sort of explained to her.
Okay, to her.
She came to it all on her own without me saying anything. Hint, hint. Anyway. PG Dale, PG. Isn't that pretty?
Someone's gonna get a hurtin' real bad.
Oh, I won't do anything to you.
I'm going to get my hair done, so excuse my messy hair.
Oh, and it's lovely already, at least the smell. I just went, mm-hmm.
See, this is how you win
my
back.
Am I confusing you? Am I making you lose? No, nope. Look at that perfect symmetry. It's like I didn't even matter.
Oh,
matter. Okay, screw it up now. Take two. Okay, this is with a spoon, as I had mentioned that she should have done before. Just pick it up. I know. It's okay. It's not a matter. People will forgive. Okay. Okay. And that's a good coverage you've got with the spoon this time. Mm-hmm. And your spoon skills have improved from that debacle last week. So, does not exist. Does not exist, and I haven't seen it.
All right. So that goes over the zucchini.
That looks quite delicious, actually.
Yes, and then we put a layer of this.
Layer of this. And this
which is the cottage cheese.
Cottage cheese.
Basil, oregano,
basil,
egg.
Basil, oregano, egg. And that is mozzarella in the corner there?
Yeah, we have to grate that.
So my cheese combo apparently was just fiction.
Yes, it was.
But as what a fiction it was.
Well, he has overcome his high cholesterol, but we don't want him to go back to high cholesterol.
No.
So that is why we have skim milk mozzarella.
And he needs a nice rub tonight with ointment.
All right.
What's that?
I will absolutely do that. I forgot the last
one. Oh, no. I will insist upon it.
Okay.
Because, you know, after making all of this food.
Yes. You've been working so hard.
Look at my hand action. Ah. All that estrogen in the water supply is paying.
Okay. That's our layer of that.
Perfect.
And then we're going to take two cups of packed spinach and we're going to put that on top of this.
Not chopped, though.
No.
I'm just going to layer them. And the baby spinach is actually excellent for this operation.
Yes,
it is. And you open the box, remove the lid.
Like spinach.
Yes, we do. It's good in everything. It's a good breakfast meal. It's a good lunch meal.
Omelets.
It's a good snacking meal. It goes good with martinis and beer. it's an all round.
Well,
beer. You have a few of them, trust me. Yeah. That's spinach. That's some good tasting spinach, darling.
Yes, it is. Mm-hmm. Oh, and this is all washed beforehand.
Oh, yes.
So not to worry.
Now, are you growing spinach?
Yes, I am. I'm going to try to grow spinach this year. I've never tried it before, so I'm going to give it a whirl.
Yeah, I think it'd be great. You've got the cucumbers and the tomatoes, the basil.
Although,
yes.
As you see, I'm wearing a sweatshirt because the weather, the temperature dropped kind of dramatically on us here.
Yeah, well, 2 degrees, but no snow.
No snow. Yeah. And a couple of my plants died. Very sad. But, all right, rest of the sauce.
Rest of the sauce. I'll just pick that up. Thank you. Shall I spoon it for you?
No, that's okay.
All right, she's going to spoon it. She's taken on a quite a roll now. You see that she's hit the ground running. I've obviously. It's okay. I like it when they take over and they be free and, you know, you teach a man to fish and they make quinoa lasagna. Song and dance.
Okay, and now we're going to grate a cup and a half of mozzarella, and we're going to put that on top, and then we're going to bake it.
Lovely. What are you doing? I just stepped out for a second, and what? Everything got grated and mixed and cheesed, and you did all that by yourself? No, you didn't, of course not. It's the magic of the video.
Yeah. All right, so now we're done. We put it
in. We are done.
preheated 350-degree oven.
350.
For 35 to 40 minutes.
35, because the quinoa is cooked, really. I shall open the door. No, I guess not. I'm not doing anything anymore. I am filling.
You look pretty there, baby.
Yes. I'm coming. I'm coming around the bend. I think it's ready.
Do you?
I do think
it's... Let me give you that idea.
The beeping and putting the mittens on.
Ta-da!
And that is my quinoa lasagna.
We're not actually eating it right now.
No.
We made it because I'm going to get my hair done.
Yes. And then that's what her hair looks like before.
And then we're going to go to church. And yep. Then we will warm it up mm-hmm. when we go to church.
It looks delicious.
I'm curious. I don't know how that's going to stay together.
I don't know. Well, I think maybe it'll settle. Maybe it needs to set.
Well, it does. It does. The recipe says to let it set, like lasagna. Mm. But I don't know. We'll see. I think it's going to be messy, folk.
Yeah.
Ta-da.
Yeah.
Ta-da.
Ta-da.
And I have the nutrition facts, and I will post them.
Yes. I'll get them for you.
The end. Dig into a good piece with the... Let's see.
Oops. Good piece. Got everything. Zucchini, quinoa.
Cottage cheese. It's lasagna in name and taste. It's really light. It's not... You know, it's got it. It's got the thing.
Yeah?
I mean, the base of the lasagna really didn't help because I don't know what's holding it together. But taste-wise, that is delicious.
Right on. Okay, folks, we're going to enjoy our dinner.
And the spinach. Woo-hoo.
Two thumbs up. Right on. Okay. Calorically, it's fantastic. Ta-ta. Okay, folks, I'm mid-chew. It is really, really good. Oh, I got my hair done.
Oh, you're beautiful, yeah.
I would say, honestly, that if you are craving lasagna and you're on a low-calorie diet or a gluten-free diet, and you're like, just, I really want something like a comfort thing, this will absolutely, absolutely satisfy that craving.
I would agree.
We will make it again. We have a friend who is on a gluten-free, she's a celiac. We have to, you know, I'm going to put some aside for her because I'm sure she's going to love it.
Oh boy, would it.
We've enjoyed it immensely. I haven't even got to the salad yet because I'm concentrating on this.
I almost ate all the salad.
He almost ate all the salad.
And the bread.
I have to say, it's fantastic. Try it. I'm going to put up the nutritional information, and I'm telling you, it's like 300 and something calories per that gigantic slab.
I did not realize that.
Yes.
What is lasagna normally?
7.
Eight.
Depends on how much cheese you put in.
Oh.
Anyways, 6, 7, 8. Okay. The pasta itself usually adds a lot of calories. So
yeah, pasta I could see. That's why the quinoa comes in. Yeah. Oh, so this is a health conscious.
This is a very health conscious. See, I fooled you.
So Garfield would like.
And for my darling, so we keep him not having high cholesterol, it has very, very low cholesterol per serving. So
thank you.
Bon appetit.
Ta da da.